That's our humble politicians asking the humble Hindustani for votes. But the way in which they do it isn't humble at all. It's stylish, it's cool, it's grand. Where do they get this money from? What the hell are electoral bonds? My name is Naman and welcome to Crux. 69% of the total political funding in India is from unknown sources. Only 31% is from known sources. Political parties say they have no idea where most of their money is coming from. They just spend it. So innocent they are. Most of this unknown money is black money. Black money and politics in India go hand in hand. The Supreme Court of India has called elections a naked display of black money. This is a problem. To make the system transparent and remove black money from politics in India, the government has come up with a mission. Bond. Electoral bond. The plan is simple. A person, a corporation, goes to an SBI branch and deposits money and provides KYC information. And in return, they get an electoral bond. This electoral bond won't have the name of the person donating, the party they're donating to, it'll just have the money, because that's what's important. Now, this electoral bond can be provided to any party. You don't have to give your details to the party, and the party doesn't have to tell anyone where this money came from. They just gotta spend it. But organizations like Association for Democratic Reform are opposing this. They say that with these bonds, the little money that was declared by the parties will now also be anonymous. Traditionally, the parties were supposed to tell us who gave what money if the money was more than 20,000. And companies in their financial statements would tell us which party they gave how much money to. Now with the bonds, the party and the companies don't have to tell us anything, just that they got electoral bonds. So according to ADR, this brings more opacity, not transparency. But what about the second goal? Remove black money. Yes. That's what the government has been talking about. They say the reason big donors use black money is because they don't want to be identified. The big donors don't want people to know how much money they give to big parties. Now the question is this the only way to stop black money in politics? Should we bow down to the will of these big donors and let them be anonymous? Especially when the citizen of India is being asked to give all his information to the government, Aadhaar. And will this even remove black money? Or people will figure out ways to go around it, like they did with demonetization. People have many theories, and we have one too. Suppose person A has black money. He wants to give this money to party X. He can't buy electoral bonds. But wait, what if person A goes to person B who has white money? Person A gives the black money to person B. Person B uses the white money to buy the electoral bonds and gives them to party X. Done. Why would person B do this, you ask? Well, donations to political parties are tax exempt. So person B won't have to pay tax on the donated money, but still have the black money. So in effect, he turned a profit. Person A uses the black money, party X gets the black money, person B evades taxes. Works for all. Do like, comment, share, subscribe, marry and adopt us. And watch this space for more.